Allah didn't already say, وَلَنَبْلُوا أَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. We're going to test you with your children, your money, loss of life, fruits. Congratulations to those who are going to be patient. Allah already didn't already say that? You know, you should be mentally prepared. Didn't Allah already say, أَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ أَمْ حَسِبَ النَّاسَ أَنْ يُتْرَكُوا أَنْ يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Have people assumed they're just going to say they believe, they're not going to be put through tough tests? So these tough tests came. And the Sahaba saw them and said, this is exactly what Allah said. I am seeing the word of Allah miraculously fulfilled. Just like they saw Rome dominated and come back, that was a miraculous fulfillment of Allah's word. The armies coming to attack Medina was a miraculous fulfillment of Allah's word to them. It's a miracle. They're overjoyed at this crisis situation because they see in it something that a non-believer can't possibly see. A believer sees something that a non-believer just can't see. They don't have the eyes to see that. You know, لَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا. They have eyes they can't see with them. The hypocrite said, مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. Contrast that. In the same surah, the hypocrite said, Allah and His Messenger promised us nothing but deception. Same surah. And now the believer sees it and says, this is exactly what Allah and His Messenger promised. The exact opposite. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا. And this event did not increase them in anything except in more faith, وَتَسْلِيمًا. And they were even more submissive, more continually submissive to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ. Out of the believers there are real men. صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ. They have fulfilled the promise. They have been true to the promise that Allah took from them. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ. Then among them are those who've already given their pledge. Nahb in Arabic is like nadhr. Nadhr is a pledge. When you dedicate something, when you make something mandatory on yourself, Ya Allah, get me into this college, and if I get into this college, I'll fast for 3 days. This would be a nadhr or nahb. You offer something. It's like Allah is saying, these sahaba said, Ya Allah, give me Jannah, I offer you my life. And Allah says, some of them have already made their payment. Some of them already went to Jannah. مِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ. Among them are the ones who've already made their payment. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah has purchased from believers their monies and their selves in exchange for paradise. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ. And there's among them who is waiting to make his payment. He's waiting to dedicate his life to Allah. He's begging Allah, Ya Allah, don't let my days go by in waste. Don't let my days go by in entertainment. Ya Allah, make me from those people that make their payment to you. They serve your deen. They do something for you. مِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرْ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. And they wouldn't change it for the world. That's how I'd like to change that, you know, translate. وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. They would not replace this priority and this enthusiasm to serve the religion with anything else. There's nothing more valuable to them. لِيَجْزِيَ اللَّهُ الصَّادِقِينَ بِصِدْقِهِمْ. So that Allah can compensate the truthful on account of their truth. وَيُعَذِّبَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ إِنْ شَاءَ. And he may punish the hypocrites if he wants.